I have told you that I will tell you about the quadrants. So here you can see that this is the vertical plane. Of course, these planes are transparent, they are very thin, okay, and their length and width is infinite. Length and width of the vertical plane HP and horizontal plane vertical plane VP and horizontal plane HP is infinite, okay. And here you can see that this is the intersection of HP and VP, that is the XY line, right. Now just see, the total space is divided into four parts or four quadrants, okay, due to the presence of HP and VP. For time being, you just forget the profile plane or the side plane, only consider the HP and VP, okay. So now this, consider this part of the space which is above HP and in front of VP. So that is the first quadrant. Now this space which is above HP and behind VP, second quadrant. This space which is below HP and behind VP, third quadrant. This space which is below HP and in front of VP, that is the fourth quadrant. These are the four quadrants, okay. If you just observe in this direction, once again I will explain, just observe in this direction, and then this VP will be seen as a line like this. This line, suppose this line is VP, VP will be seen as a line like this. HP will be seen as a horizontal line like this. So VP is this vertical line, HP is this horizontal line, okay, if you observe in this direction, okay. So HP will be seen only as a line, horizontal line, this one here it is shown. VP will be shown only as a line, seen as only line, if you observe in this direction, okay. So these are the two lines, okay. So now this space is first quadrant. Q stands for quadrant. So this space stands is first quadrant. Then this is the second quadrant. You can see that this space is above HP and in front of VP. This space is above HP and behind VP. That is the second quadrant. Third quadrant, that means this space which is behind VP and below HP is the third quadrant. And this is the fourth quadrant, that means below HP and in front of VP. Okay. Now we can use two methods of projection, that is first angle method of projection and third angle method of projection. Now mostly as per our syllabus, we are going to use the first angle method of projection. According to the first angle method of projection, the object is assumed to be lying in the first quadrant. Object is assumed to be lying in the first quadrant. If you go for the third angle method of projection, the object is assumed to be lying in the third quadrant. Okay. In the first quadrant means above HP in front of VP. Okay. So when the object is in the first quadrant, after rotation, what will happen? The front view will remain above XY line and the top view will go below XY line. After rotation of HP, top view will go below XY line and front view will remain above XY line after rotation. In first angle method of projection, that means if the object is assumed to be lying in the first quadrant. Assume that this is the object. It is projected on VP here like this. And it is projected on HP here like this. And after rotation, what will happen? This portion of HP will overlap with this portion of VP. And this portion of HP will overlap with this portion of VP. Okay. And you will get only one plane. Here you will be seeing only one line. Okay. After rotation. So what will happen after rotation? Front view will go above XY line. This point indicates XY line. Right. So front view will be above XY line. And top view will be below XY line in first angle method of projection. That means when the object is assumed to be in the first quadrant. Okay. Here also again you can have the idea about the quadrants and the symbols. Okay. Again you know that this is VP. Actually this is the actual VP. Here you can see that vertical plane, it lies above HP as well as below HP. Similarly this horizontal plane, this is the horizontal plane. It lies in front of VP as well as behind VP. Okay, so this is the object according to first angle method of projection. This one is the object. Okay, this is VP. Here, this is VP above HP and it is also below HP. Okay, so here the object is in front of VP and the projection of the object on VP is called as the front view. So, this is the front view. Okay, so this is a truncated cone. Truncated means this cone is cut, the apex of this cone is cut. Okay, So you can get the shape, the front view like this. Front view is seen as a trapezoid like this. This is the front view of this object. Okay. And this object is projected on HP also. If you observe this object from the top, you can see two circles, this smaller circle and this larger circle. Okay. So these circles, concentric circles are there. Okay. These circles, two circles are nothing but the HP or the top view. These two circles constitute the top view. Top is nothing but only two circles. If you observe from the top, you see two circles. If you observe in this direction from the front, you can see the trapezoid like this. Okay. So this concept is used to have the symbols. So this is the symbol of first angle. Symbol of first angle. So you can see this trapezoid and these two circles. Okay. So if you observe the object from this direction, you can see this circle and this circle. You can see both the circles. So see the location. Only difference is between left side and right side. So here you can see that these two circles are on the right side and the trapezoid is at the left side. That is the symbol for first angle. Symbol for first angle. Okay. Now, according to third angle method of projection, this is the first quadrant. Okay, this is the second quadrant. Generally, we don't keep the object in the second quadrant. Because what will happen? Both the views will be on a single plane. There will be overlapping of the views. Okay. Because after rotation, what will happen? Top view will also go here above XY line. Front view will also above XY line. And these two views will overlap. There will be some sort of khichdi there. Okay. So in order to avoid that, we never assume that the object is lying in the second quadrant. Either we assume the object in the first quadrant or in the third quadrant. Never in the second and the fourth quadrant. Okay, so here this is HP and the second quadrant means the space above HP and behind VP. This is second quadrant. Now the third quadrant, object may be lying in the third quadrant, this object here, okay, below HP and behind VP. Okay, this is the third quadrant. This is the vertical plane VP. Okay, so this object is behind VP, below HP. Okay, and now here, according to third angle method of projection, the observer is located here at the top and this plane is supposed to be transparent. So the observer is observing from the top and this plane of projection lies between the observer and the object according to third angle method of projection. So here the observer is present. This is the plane of projection. This is the object. Okay, now the observer can see the object. In spite of the fact that this HP lies in between the observer and the object, because this HP is a transparent plane. HP is a transparent plane. Okay. And the observer can observe the object through this transparent plane, say a glass, a thin glass. Okay. And it is projected on the glass itself or on the HP, the plane itself. Okay. So if the observer is observing from the top, he can see this circle, smaller circle, and this bigger circle. Okay, here the object, here also the observer is observing from the top, therefore we say top view. Okay, but here you will find that the object is lying between the observer and HP. According to first angle method of projection, the observer is lying above and the object lies between the observer and the plane of projection, right? Here also the observer is observing in this direction. Okay. From right to left, so the object is present between the observer and the plane of projection VP. Okay, and then it is projected like this. So that is the difference between the first angle method of projection and the third angle method of projection. Now, of course, this is the fourth quadrant, and fourth quadrant means the space below HP and in front of VP. This space is the fourth quadrant. Okay. So again, this is VP, HP, XY line, object. These are the projectors, front view, top view. These are projectors are drawn, front view is drawn, top view is drawn. Okay. Then the side plane, profile plane is there and the side view is seen like this. Okay. So this is the profile plane. The object can be projected on the side plane or the profile plane also. and you can get the side view besides the front view like this. Okay, and if the dimensions, now see the dimensions, if this length is 80, you will find that this length is 80, this also 80 length. Okay, so let us say this is length, this is width. Length is 80, width is 50, and height is 60, okay, of this particular object. Okay, so here if you draw the front view, top view and side view, you can see that in the top view this 80 length is seen here. Similarly, in the front view this dimension is also 80. Okay, then this height is 60, this is also 60, and this is also 60. So height is common with front view and side view, length is common with front view and top view. Okay, and remember that the width 50 is common with top view and side view. So this is the width 50, it is common with top view. This is 50 and this is also 50. So these two dimensions are common with top view and side view. This dimension, that is the width, is common with top view and side view. With these two views, the width dimension, that is 50, is common. Okay, similarly the length 80 is common with front view and top view. Length 80 is common with front view and top view. Okay, and the height 60 is common with front view and side view. So these simple concepts are very important. Try to understand them carefully and develop your visualization, develop your imagination. Okay, that will help you a lot. Okay, so so many jobs in technology, in engineering, need a lot of imagination. They need a lot of visualization, logic, and all these things are needed. So the study of this subject will definitely improve your logical thinking, improve your visualization, ability to visualize the things, and your ability to imagine the things. Your creativity will be improved. Okay, and you can have the ability to change the world. Engineers have the ability to change the world. You can definitely change the world as an engineer. You can make the world a better place to live, and that is the job of an engineer. So my dear engineer friends, please go ahead, please study carefully, okay, and watch all my videos, subscribe my channel. It's my request to observe more and more videos and share. Okay, so I'm interested in the that all my friends, all my student friends should learn more and more about technology, and our nation should grow with you all. Okay, so thank you my dear friends. I think this much is sufficient for today, and further we'll study in the next videos details of the orthographic projection, various complicated objects we'll be studying. So thank you very much.